Lagna, wow. I have a friend, you know, Saturn in Lagna. He stays, I will not tell the name of the city. In North India, in a very big city. It's not Delhi, somewhere. Everything is there in his life. Whatever a person can imagine, he has a very nice girlfriend. Maybe he's about to get married. Or he has a school, you know. His father had given him a school in gift. Can you believe it? So much wealth, prosperity, so much is there. But that one Saturn sitting in the ascendant, the moment you call him, hey, how's life? Oh, life is terrible. Why? Oh, that this Kamwali Bai, na, that lady who cleans, that servant, she didn't come. Driver did not come. He cheated me. She cheated me. Now everybody gets cheated. Everybody is made. Sometimes they get delayed. But why does it affect him so much? Because Saturn is the king now. He's telling, I will only allow negativity here.
True.
So whenever he sees negativity, what happens? He's like, zoop, take it. And if you tell him that, hey, you know, we'll go to a trip. It's great. We will go here. We will go there. We will do this. We will do that. He will start asking you, oh, but what if, you know, the driver doesn't come? I mean, why in the universe are you so pessimistic? The driver, of course, that's a possibility that the driver does not come, but maybe the driver comes. But he will think driver will not come only. Always that will happen.
True, yeah.
That's because Saturn is the king. He is telling, I will decide. And Rahu Ketu, of course, how we can miss? Rahu is that which eclipses the sun, my God.
Yeah, and it's in the first house in ascendant.
So it is like saying, I will eclipse everybody else. I will eat away everybody's sun. Because I already told you that sun itself is a existence of our individual unique identity separate from God. Now imagine there is somebody else who comes and says, I will take that also away from you. And that is why they say Rahu is the higher version of Saturn. Rahu Vata Shani. Kuja Vatak Mangal. That Ketu is the higher version of Mars.
Mars, yeah.
Why do they say that? Oh, they've just said, you know, and
He's
we are
the
following it. They are saying, and we are following. Yeah, we have to
He
follow,
kind
right?
of has tendency to be
They've said, how can we deny? You know, we must follow it. And that's very the funny thing about Rahu Ketu is you have to understand Mars and Saturn. If you don't understand Mars and Saturn, you will not understand what Rahu Ketu is. Because Rahu Ketu are higher versions of these two. So if you don't know these two, what will you understand? Saturn is what basically? Saturn is that tendency inside us which says that, look, you lost something. Wherever Saturn is sitting or aspecting, you will get a feeling there. Oh, you lost it. Saturn will give you, as you know, Krishna says in the Gita, hankering and lamentation. Lamentation is Saturn. Oh, I lost it. I lost him. I lost her. I lost that job. Everything is like, because Saturn represents those things which are away from you, right? So wherever Saturn is sitting, he will throw you opposite of that house. He sits with Venus. Go away from Venus. He's aspecting Venus. Go away from Venus. And Mars is opposite. Mars is hankering. I want. So wherever Mars is sitting, you will always have an insatiable craving in that house. Always you will be like, oh, I wish I could have this, you know. And that's what the Gita says. These two are how we suffer, actually. And that's the fun part, you know. Both are malefics and they are opposites.
Yeah.
I mean, if you say Saturn is a malefic and Mars is opposite, so then you should have said, oh, maybe Mars is a benefic then. Mm-hmm. Or you make a rule. No, Mars is malefic. So Saturn is a benefic, right? Mm-hmm. So these are like two sides of the same coin. Because the Gita says the living entity in this world is always doing one of the two things. Either he's hankering or he's lamenting.
True.
And then Krishna says that Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma, that shloka is there. One who rises above this, his spiritual life begins. That's not the perfection of spiritual life. That's the beginning. So whenever you see people, they will talk of big things and materialistic attachments. They will have habits like drinking, smoking or eating meat or anything. They're obsessed about all this. And then you hear that they're talking about spirituality. You have to understand what is going on. The process has not yet started only. Because when you are having addictions, you are controlled by something, right? That means you are hankering. I want it more and more and more and more. So when we rise above these two by doing spiritual practices, then our spiritual journey starts. Mm-hmm. And then finally we realize that we are not separate from God, you know. We are not the sun, actually. Then we will realize that our original identity is in linking ourselves to God. Mm-hmm. Then Mars and Saturn cannot trouble you. Why? Because now there is no empire. There is nothing for Mars to conquer, you see. And there is nothing for Saturn to torment you of. Because they say you cannot lose anything which you don't own. Mm. Why people keep crying? I lost this person, that person. Because you still believe that you own that person, right? Mm-hmm. If that conception, suppose there's a big nice Rolls Royce standing in front of you. Mm-hmm. No? And then somebody comes and hits it with a brick like this. And the light is gone. Now you will feel bad. Oh my God, you know, such a beautiful Rolls Royce Phantom. And see how they broke this glass. But you will not start crying. Mm-hmm. Why? Because it's not yours, right? So you are not attached, basically. Mm. So you are like, anyways. So then you see Saturn can't harm you. Then you don't have to do all these funny remedies. Fasting on Saturdays, feeding crows, all funny remedies of Saturn. Mm-hmm. If you want to remedy Saturn, just remedy your conception that you own something.
True.
Because if you don't become aware of that, then what will happen? Today we'll do some Saturn remedy. Maybe he will be like, okay, let me allow you to keep it for some time. And after some time, okay, now I'm back, you see. So the problem doesn't solve. It's not getting, there's no purification inside. And Mars, I will rule the territory once. That is why they say, na, Ketu is flag. Mars is the fighting battle. When you win the fight, that's Ketu. I have won the battle. You know, that's like, this is the
flag.
So then there is no territory to conquer. Then Mars cannot torment you. How do you feel when you are hankering after something? Miserable, right? Oh my God, I want it, I want it, I want it, I want it. Life becomes like hell. And Krishna also says in the Gita, Trividasyam Narakayate, three gateways to hell. So if we want to rise above Mars, Saturn, Rahu and Ketu, and what's the link of Rahu and Saturn?
Rahu kind of behaves like Saturn as well.
Why do they say that Rahu, although Saturn gives you suffering and sorrow, when it comes to giving pain, Saturn is the worst malefic. Okay? But why do they say that Rahu is even more malefic than Saturn? Because Saturn will only give you the pains which are already there in your account.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you bet your wife in past life, this life, she will ditch you. Or maybe this life you become the man and you become the girl and she will become the boyfriend and he will ditch you. So you'll be fired from job at the age of 29 or 30, whatever it is.
Mm-hmm.
So Saturn, what he does is he's coming and clearing the account. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. But what Rahu does is, Rahu says, give me the book, I will write new stuff there.
Wow.
Saturn is just like, okay, you did 10 things, I will give you 10 things. Rahu is like, hey, wait, I will add 10 more. Then you give him 20, not 10.
Mm-hmm.
Rahu gives you that conception. Wherever Rahu is sitting, you will have that conception that this is correct. This is right.
Mm-hmm.
Rahu and Jupiter are very similar. Jupiter is faith, wisdom. What is faith basically? You think that's correct, right? That is why they say God is great. They actually believe that God is great. Now, he is great definitely, but that statement reflects the mentality.
Mm-hmm.
And Jupiter and Rahu are very similar. Both are expansive, one is explosive. So that is why Rahu is said to be a higher version of Saturn. Because if Rahu is not there, what Saturn will do? He will come, he will check your entire database, 10 million, billion lifetimes. He will check 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, all clear. You have suffered for the next 100 lifetimes and your karma is finished. But Rahu is like, I will not let that happen. I will put new desires. You had a breakup? No problem. I'll find another girlfriend for you. No problem. Another girlfriend. You lost a job? No problem. Hey, look, there's another job there. So you go on and on adding in that list, you know. And every lifetime, Saturn will come and he will like, okay, that's the new list for this life. Take it. That's all I will say. Any other questions, queries or comments? You did not speak anything, but anyways.
This was all about you.
No, I guess we have around 5 to 7 minutes. If you have one or two questions, maybe I can answer.
Sure. So Ketu in the Lagna, so we were just discussing about Rahu and Ketu. So if Ketu is in the Lagna, how will it, like, you also said, like, Lagna will also impact, like, who you are, your body, how you
I have won already.
Mm-hmm.
I have won the battle.
Mm-hmm. So Ketu in the Lagna is just like, they will just... Would it be like they would be operating like without logic or anything like that? Because Ketu is a headless planet.
See,
but then the headless planet is sitting where the head is.
That is why Ketu is headless, na? Because you are in the illusion that you have conquered a territory.
Mm-hmm.
It is the higher version of Mars.
Mm-hmm.
What foolish territory you have conquered? You just have a job, you have some pennies in your bank account. One day Carl will come and he's like, everything get out. Eighth house is activated, finished. Which house Ketu? Ketu rules which sign? Scorpio.
Scorpio.
Why he doesn't rule Sagittarius? Why Pisces? Why he rules Scorpio only? And that is why when Ketu Dasha comes, they say that, oh, people feel headless. Even in Antar Dasas, you see how miserable it is sometimes. If there is spirituality.
Yeah.
The question is, why are Ketu Dasha so miserable? You will see the fun part about Ketu is that's the funny thing. Either you are happy materially or you are sad, you will be miserable. Because what Ketu is trying to tell you, hey, look, you thought you conquered this land. Mm-hmm. But now Scorpio is active. It's not your territory, it's somebody else. So in Ketu Dasha, what happens? You think you have something, but then you don't know that how to use it or what do I make out of it. That's why it is headless. Because when the eighth house of death gets activated, everything which you have, you are stripped of everything. So then you get a feeling as if nothing is there with you, even when everything is there. That's why you will see people running Ketu Dasas. Everything is there. Marriage is there, career is, but they'll be like, what's the problem? During Ketu Antar or Mahadasas, we get a flavor of death. And death is very painful.
Yeah.
There are some statements which say that when you die, you experience a pain of 40,000 scorpion bites simultaneously.
Wow.
And some say it's not 40,000, it's 10,000. But the question is, how does it matter?
True.
And imagine what happens when death comes. Dasha means what? What is the meaning of Dasha? Dasha means temporarily something is active, right?
Yeah.
When you say that the Dasha of 8th Lord is running, it will not run for 100 years. Mm-hmm. If Venus is your 8th Lord, at max it will run for how many years? 20 years? But yeah. When death comes, what happens? That's the only house which is active. All the houses are ruined. Mars, Scorpio Lord is who? Mars, right? Mm-hmm. The body is dissolved. Moon gets debilitated in Scorpio. You're most miserable during death. Oh my God, so painful. Mm-hmm. That is why people say, na, as sure as death. Or they say, I felt like dying.
Yeah.
So when Ketu is in the ascendant, what will happen is, depending on other placements, the person can have a very strong conception that I own a territory, but he will always be feeling that this is not my territory. Because it is actually not yours. Because Krishna says in the Gita, na, Bhoktaram Yajna Tapasyam Sarva Loka Maheshwaram, I am the undisputed emperor of all the worlds. Mm-hmm. So he's the actual king out there. So Ketu tells you, look, you are not the king. But Ketu also tells that you look, you thought you have this territory, you have your flag. But you are not. So that becomes the definition of success in life. Oh, nothing is mine. Maybe everything is mine. That is why they are the significators of confusion. Why do they say Rahu Ketu shows confusion? Because you think you own something and then, no, sorry, we don't own it, you know. And depending on the whole chart, it will tell where the flow is happening. And Rahu is like, I will write 20 more pages in this book. I will go on and on writing pages. That's what Rahu is.
Sounds good. That was very informative session, Babaji.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thanks for coming to my channel.
Well, my pleasure.
Okay,
see you some other time, then we'll have this time. Of course, you didn't speak, so I will let you also speak this time.
For sure, we will have another one, yeah.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye, thank you.